So somehow by the mercy of Vrindavan, because Vrindavan is so merciful, and everyone, I mean, there's verses, so many verses in Puranas glorifying Vrindavan. It says it sins elsewhere. If you commit sins elsewhere, it means outside of Vrindavan, those sins, you'll have to pay, for those sins. You'll get a reaction. You'll have to pay for those sins by going to hell or suffering heavily in your next life. But any sins committed in Vrindavan are resolved in Vrindavan itself. You're resolved and you're absolved. So you make some heavy sin or whatever, then you'll get the punishment right here, right now in Vrindavan, coming at you. Ta! So this is because another place is because the mother loves you like anything. Sometimes she loves you so much she cracks you, she gives you a slap to reprimand you. But after she slaps you, her love grows because you generally respond in a positive way. Because she's slapping you to reform your character, or reform your behavior, or attitude, or whatever. So then you grow in newer and better ways after the interaction with your mother. So there's verses in the Radharas Sudaniti, that compare Vrindavan to a mother, Vrindatavi. Vrindavan's like a mother. So being like a mother, she's very merciful, and she's very compassionate, and very forgiving. Always giving and always forgiving. It's a very extraordinary quality. This is the quality of true love. The quality of true love is always giving and always forgiving. So this is the nature of Brajadam. And everything's personal. Vrindavan is Radharani and Krishna. You can't separate.